The end of the United States shadow government's satanic ritual abuse. The mind control experimenters and psychic assassins were given 1 year to experiment and kill me. They said to me in the last week before the 1 year anniversary of Halloween that they had screwed up badly. I was supposed to die. While I did manage to dodge each attempt on my life and prevent harm to others, they easily stole 35 years of my health and longevity, not to mention my happiness. I know this is irresponsible to say, but if I knew what they were going to put me through in the beginning, I would have ended it like many other victims have done and taken away the data and practice that they were seeking. So writing this book exposing the people, the technologies, their tactics, and helping others plan a strategy for taking out their weapons systems to defend themselves helps me heal. You are lost in the matrix of lies. Like in the movie The Matrix, people are so ignorant about these decades-old weapons which seem so science fiction-like, that they are not willing to help targeted people, nor can they comprehend the pure evil that their tax dollars support. And since most people have no experience or practice with neural influencing technologies, they could be used at any time against a victim through EEG heterodyning. Most people have been tamed and dulled into captivity like a broken horse. The illusion of freedom is good enough now, and the self-reassuring bullshit that we mindlessly chant in our national anthem, the land of the free and home of the brave, quells our subconscious insecurities of it not being true. It is as if all the people of this country have been subdued into complacency and compliance with electromagnetic Prozac, hypnotube sleight of hand misdirection, and information overload shutdown. Experiments described by scientists working in the field say that at 5 frequency modes the induced brain impulses and voices sound synthetic and their mind feels the induced neural influences, but at 12 modes or higher the subject can't perceive the influence and mistakes the modulated voice as their own thoughts. The Russian woodpecker transmitters have 12 modes according to Dr. Bird. But the United States agents brag that the United States has the only global mind network. People appear on the War Room global grid as one of the 1,000 points of light. I am one of the few people who have been released from the psychotronic torture concentration camps in such a short time. Most endure many years of torture under the weapon. I still fight for a reconstruction of America back to constitutional values and transparency in government. I get asked to be an expert witness at least once a week by someone suing the government for this kind of abuse, false imprisonment, or death of a family member. There have been so many attempts at a class action lawsuit, but all have failed. It usually takes 20 years for the government to release the documents validating what victims of other experiments in history tried to get the public to recognize while they were alive. This is an informational war, no bombs, and no missiles. Even the hacking of the human mind is classified as an information weapon. I met with one ex-CIA agent who is fighting the shadow government. He never told me why, whether he was a torture experiment. He had bodyguards with him when we met. Clearly, he knows how corrupt the agency is. The ex-FBI agents and other ex-government agents were cautious in different ways. I was tortured to the brink of death many times, and like in the movie V is for Vendetta, I quit fearing death. They already killed me. So we share signal intelligence data which different groups have been analyzing while trying to reverse engineer the nervous system disrupting weapons and find a worldwide cure to disable them. Ideally we would like to show by introducing a vaccine what idiots the militants in charge of these various classifications of weapons are. We need to knock out their surveillance capabilities and nervous system influence, then break through the information gridlock using creative means. The $100 billion weapon system could be rendered useless. That is our immediate goal, since justice is a long way off and waking up the population from their hypnotic dream has proved impossible given the complete control of the information streams. If you are reading this book, you most likely had to get it directly from the source, or in order for a mainstream publisher to accept it, I had to publish it as fiction. I openly lecture around the country on these weapons whose forums are free and open to the public. If you have interest, network yourself in and come to one of the monthly gathering. There are groups everywhere in the world. The protocols of the hypocrisy. So, in these approved torture and kill statistical experiments, they must follow strict protocols. As strange as it might seem, they can try to kill anyone in the world or make that target kill other people using information weapons in addition to gaslighting through stalking, but they cannot chemically poison, shoot, or assassinate the subject using conventional methods. I assume it would bias their efficacy data. Saddam was a pawn used to justify invasion. We cannot gloss over the important testimony from Saddam Hussein as reported by USA Today newspaper in 1992. The important deduction to make from his statement that the CIA tried to kill him by inducing a heart attack and a stroke is that he was assaulted by the Satan system, which means he was EEG heterodyned. He is tracked anywhere in the world. They should not have had any trouble finding him. But they did. They would also have done a mind meld and known ahead of time either where the weapons of mass destruction were or that Iraq didn't have any. This is proof that the weapons of mass destruction argument of invasion was a lie. Tony Blair of the UK said that one of his scientists said that there were weapons of mass destruction. That scientist came forward and denied what Tony Blair said. The scientist ended up dead from a bizarre suicide a week later. The web of lies pile many layers deep. Now the funny part. Satan was used on me and the remote heart attack and stroke sensations were a major part of the experimentation I endured for a year. I am in good health and wasn't too concerned about a stroke. It was difficult to tell if they could actually cause vasoconstriction and increase my blood pressure or if it was another EEG heterodyne hoax. The Army has published documents we hold that show that they mapped out the sensory pathways of the brain completely. My EEG cloner told me that they bend over causing the blood to rush to their heads and in addition put pressure on their heads with their hands or a tight baseball cap and because I feel everything that they do, it feels like they are causing a pressure buildup in my head. They said that they pedaled on a standing bicycle to increase their heart rates which would increase my heart rate slightly but it would feel like my heart was pounding out of my chest because our sensory perceptions were linked or cloned. I would take my pulse but it wouldn't feel all that unusual. So it is difficult to say if they were trying to assassinate Saddam or just make him panic which allows them to gain more control and since people think of the evilest things they are going to do in revenge when tortured, it was a way to understand his possible capabilities. This would not only provoke Saddam which partially led us to the current war but allowed them to know in his angriest moment what he was planning to do or now provoked to do. Incredible isn't it, how criminal, careless, and stupid the CIA and MI5 are? Tens of billions of dollars in war, thousands of lives lost, and many thousands more psychotronically tortured daily worldwide and traditionally tortured in Iraq. 35 million people have died due to the secrecy since EEG heterodyning was discovered that it could have saved. They have to keep it a secret now because the atrocities, stupidity, and treasonous crimes under the Constitution have reached epic proportions that people would lose all faith in our leaders' abilities to govern wisely if it were widely known. We are in the darkest period of American and human history but secrecy and ignorance keeps it vastly unknown. Appeal to Port Goss, current CIA director. Porter, do you remember your time at Hotchkiss, where your values were shaped? Do you remember when the headmaster would appeal to the students who committed some out-of-control prank to do the honorable thing and come forward and take responsibility for what they had done? Americans are appealing to you to come forward, be an honorable man again and tell the public what is being done to them. This is too important. It is not the time to lie, maintain secrets, or to hide. This is what will define you as a man and your legacy. Two worlds and two lies. There are two different worlds, each has some truth and a lot of deception. Which one is the Matrix virtual world? The electromagnetic mind control world is obviously composed of signals that feel as real as the ones from physical sensory stimuli. It reveals the truth about the psychological and informational deception matrix in the physical realm and its sets of controls become obvious. From that matrix of deception one can view those in the mind network as deceived by the virtual pain and panic, controlled by electromagnetic pulses of energy in the brain. Unfortunately, neither perspective is pure or even close to the one all-encompassing, unwavering truth. We as a species for better or for worse have unthinkingly taken the evolutionary path towards inner space, towards a virtual subjective experience with each piece specialized for an objective function of a machine disconnected and not representative of what our race valued or hoped to become, which I believe is for each person to be fully aware, connected, and an important part of each and every decision affecting their happiness, well-being, and future. At the minimum we hope we can trust each other and to look out for each other if we don't participate in those decisions. Also, not the case. Secrecy is our undoing. More brains are not better than one. Another problem with living in a heterodyned hive mind is that when any one of the collective eats everyone else if they are talking bites their tongue. The strong impulse for the jaw to clasp down from the masticator is cloned onto the other people. This is quite an annoying problem for everyone to have to synchronize their eating habits in order to avoid this. Stupid alien pranks. The naively patriotic tax batteries need to take heed at other plots that were revealed to me through synthetic telepathy. The CIA Satan practitioners told me that they had planned to mind control over 100 people to leave their gas stoves on in various neighborhoods to level several city blocks and make it look like an orchestrated terrorist act but they were called off. I suppose this isn't quite as bad as provoking a war or creating suicide terrorist bombers to crash planes into the World Trade Towers. The alien pranks are getting out of hand. The death machine. Obviously I wish I had gotten the kindly God mind control manipulation scripts when they introduced themselves with the many options between Borga, magical dwarfs, angels, God, aliens, cult, Russians, or Chinese. The United States is the most brutal, barbaric country in the world bar none. 35 million people have died from the secrecy of just one aspect of this technology alone, add another 30 million killed by the United States in all the previous wars, and no country comes clone to the death machine that we've created. Inside the minds of monsters. Let's walk a mile in their brain waves. Why do humans become corrupted by power? They may start out thinking they are honorable and doing their duty, but the power corrupts in the end. Since we are all very similar to begin with, it means that we too would probably be corrupted in their shoes. If we can understand how this mind virus spreads, we can cure mankind of this ill. Distinguishing between national defense strategists and truly grotesque and deformed minds can be difficult and may be pointless. One only needs to study the Nazi Reich and methods of psychological and informational controls to understand our own militant government since 1945. Hitler's catchphrase was to purify and create a super race. Ours is to bring democracy, a superior form of government, and the illusion of freedom to countries around the world. For Russia, it is probably similar in rationality. It is still fascism in three different forms and under three different names and flags. War is the illness. Power and control are the temptation. Greed and fame are the drivers. Honor and duty are the secondary level of skewed rationality and method of controls. Thoughtless obedience and conformity makes up the third. Welcome to the Third Reich and the final solution. There have been many architects of the matrices of deceptions. Other books go into their personal values and lives, and most have Nazi connections. We must ensure that power is not taken by the military-industry complex, whether sought or unsought. President and General Eisenhower. Military coup d'état. Hypothetically, if you were addicted to power and control and were able to rationalize your addiction by saying to yourself, I know what this society needs and how to protect them from themselves for the good of America's military might in the world, how would you go about gaining more control and power? You would play off of society's fears. You would have a Cold War with a nuclear threat with Russia. You would create or allow acts of terrorism, the term for guerrilla warfare that has been rebranded. If we translated it back, we have absurdly declared war on war. The people would allow huge concessions of their privacy and autonomy for the artificial sense of security and safety. You could rationalize all sorts of creative interpretations of existing laws, and create many more secret laws to justify your actions in the name of security. Lying to the public to create an artificial sense of freedom and choices is done easily enough with the psychological methods that have been thoroughly developed by several agencies. Control the points of influence in a society, the few people and companies that shape popular opinion, and the herd mentality of the rest of the flock will follow. Now, imagine you had a mind control weapon in your possession that could be used to silence objectors and control those points of influence. Would you use it? Absolute power corrupts absolutely. This is the grim situation we face today. To show how short-sighted and ignorant the public has become at large, I will give an absurd example similar to events that have transpired. I want to be elected president. I promise that if I'm elected, I will give 1 year tax-free to everyone. Is this bribery? Am I buying votes with a country credit card? Many people would vote for me. If I wanted more power to control world events for profit or satisfy my need for power, I could instill a fear in all Americans, whether real or imaginary. For example, I could say that the world's oil supply is being poisoned by the Arabs where much of it comes. They are placing microdevices in the million of barrels shipped to the United States that will generate a spark at random times, causing them to ignite the fuel. They are nearly too small to easily detect, and every airplane, car, refinery, and military vehicle will be turned into a bomb. The economy will be shut down and America will be ruined. We must invade these countries to stop them. I could stage a couple of random explosions at gas stations to validate these beliefs. Then I would be granted more power under war laws. I would be given bigger military budgets to control. Etc. etc. It is pretty easy to control public opinion since we are reactionary and don't dive deeper into political motives and strategies. Timeline of takeover. While I was able to trace back remote bioelectromagnetic mind reading and influencing experiments on the masses to 1976, the technology is actually much older than that when viewed through the media programming of the masses. Aliens, psychic control, and synthetic telepathy appeared on TV frequently in the popular show called The Outer Limits. These were produced and aired in 1963, the same year that Kennedy was assassinated. Kennedy gave a speech at Columbia University 10 days before he was shot. At that event, he alluded to an ominous conspiracy and said that he must alert the American people. The high office of the president has been used to foment a plot to destroy America's freedom, and before I leave this office, I must inform the citizens of their plight. John F. Kennedy. Statement made at Columbia University, November 12, 1963. I have never followed so-called conspiracy theory and never had much of an interest in politics in general. But being so brutally tortured and then discovering that there is no way to break the information to the masses like thousands of others have found out, you realize that we really lost our freedom a long time ago due to this technology. My torturers proudly confessed that they were behind the Kennedy assassination and other political manipulation. For example, they mentioned several times that Michael Dukakis's run for presidency was targeted. Strange confession. How did Kennedy find out about the mind control radar and plot to control every human brain on the planet with these giant ionospheric heater phased arrays? I believe his generals had to tell him because of the Bay of Pigs fiasco. Why were nuclear missiles that close to the United States such a threat? They had no way at the time to stop missiles from the other directions anyway. It was because Russia knew where the United States built its first over-the-horizon radar system. It was stationed in Puerto Rico and completed in 1959. By placing the radar system outside of the continental the United States at more than a 20-degree angle from zenith, the radar system bounces its signals off the ionosphere and can observe the continental the United States. For what purpose? The Russians got the same mind-reading and influencing research from the Nazi scientists, so they knew what it was for. They had to explain to President Kennedy that the Russians had placed nuclear missiles in Cuba because it is within the 20 degrees of zenith and out of the range of the radar system. It was too close. The obvious question to ask is, why would you build the radar system outside of the United States? Kennedy was rightfully and obviously very disturbed by this plot to spy and control the United States citizens through their brains' electrical activity, and being one of the last great presidents with honor and integrity this country has had, he was going to inform the people that the country has been taken over by a military coup. Since then the power-addicted idiots have plugged the hole and built many large phased arrays in Colorado, Alaska, Massachusetts, and Brazil, to name just a few. The countdown. As with all past massive human experimentation involving biological weapons, assignations, radiation, or other trials, a cooling down period is required before discovery and reporting. The lifelong torture and mind control experiments are reaching the end of their project timeline. The Air Force and Directed Energy Directorate report that they will release the information about these human trials in 25 years. That means in another 5 to 10 years they will stop them, so that the victims will die off and there will be fewer citizens that will be demanding compensation. Currently, if they had to pay out $1 million to each victim, it would cost the United States easily $10 billion. It is simply a matter of economics that human effects weapon testing is done this way. Cognitive modeling and the timeline for takeover. This biocommunications weapon came over with the Nazi scientists in 1945. President Truman signs the National Security Act of 1947 to create the CIA. The CIA begins a long streak of crimes against citizens of the world, and they continue the horrific Nazi agenda of world domination, all based on this new biofield modulation discovery. The cataloging and cloning operations of minds has never slowed down, grabbing hundreds or thousands of new minds each year, at least reported by those who figure it out. The Russians were infected with the Nazi ideals as well from their share of Nazi scientists who gave them the technology after World War II. In 1960 the United States was put under an ionospheric heater surveillance grid and the mind system fully working. 1976, the system Tammy was born, followed by Satan. In 1990s HARP came online with even greater capabilities for putting more of the world under ionospheric heating surveillance and biocommunication control, nearly completing the global human surveillance grid. See points of weakness in the grid. We can estimate the current effectiveness of the mind influencing weapons based on this timeline. We do it as follows. 1. Assuming that they were intelligent about how they collected their cognitive modeling data, they would have grabbed people that fell in the middle of normal cognitive abilities first, since that would be the lowest hanging fruit. Cognitive models with all their differences still have a bell curve distribution from some average model. 2. Assume that the development began in 1947 and will end in 2030 as per the Air Force scientists' statements to disclose the weapon to the public. That would be 83 years of cognitive modeling and collection. Let's also assume that the collection rate is uniform across the timeline, although it looks like it has been stepped up in the most recent decade. 3. We will make the assumption that the weapon needs to be 95% effective on any person or population as the end goal before disclosure or complete takeover. So at 2 sigma and further away from the normal or average, people will be immune to different cognitive mapping effects and a threat to the Nazi weapon to some varying degree. Also, we can conclude that at the writing of this book, 2006, the DOD/CIA/Nazis have mapped, 2006-1947/2030-1947, smiley face, 71.1% of the bell curve on both directions. Since the mapping of one person or feature of a mind works on the entire population represented by the area under the curve, and being 71.1% complete in terms of the timeline means that the weapon is already at 1.42 sigma efficacy or roughly 88% of the population or cognitive features of humankind. This estimate is truly frightening. The Nazis might have lost the Battle of World War II, but they may end up winning the war. Let's calculate the lower bounds of the weapon's efficacy. Let's make the assumption that entire minds need to be mapped and that they aren't transferable in terms of their features. That still means that 71.1% of the population has been automatically mapped based on the directed energy weapons directorate timelines, and assuming that there is no cooling off period for all the people who suffered and died from the weapons practice and testing. We can only hope that they need this mental crutch for their thinking and the machine didn't efficiently collect the cognitive data samples based on this paradigm. Putting it in perspective. So the chances of you being abducted and tortured by the government physically or psychotronically is about 1,000 out of 300 million each year if you are American. So that is a 1 in 4,000 chance in a lifetime if there are 75,000 victims, which doesn't include all the collateral damage of relatives, friends, strangers, and businesses affected. That's much better than winning the lottery. That is twice the possibility of having a parachute failure while skydiving. That's 1/40th the chance of developing schizophrenia from natural causes. That is why it's easy to lump psychotronic test victims in that category. It is 12 times more likely than a shark attack, but half as likely as being killed by lightning. If 3,000 people died in the 9/11 attacks, you have a 10 times greater chance of being brutalized by the United States government than being, in comparison, humanely and instantly killed by a foreign terrorist organization in the 30-year history of these secret test programs. Who should you really be afraid of? This statistic only includes psychotronic and directed energy weapons testing. It does not include the biological warfare, drug, or radiation testing they have performed in the past on citizens. These people performing these horrific experiments are the enemy within. Everyone else in the government are just unwitting participants. Most soldiers never know the real reasons that they are fighting to the death, and the public in accordance are just fed the simple reasons to support government actions. It has always been a game of redirecting anger at all the wrong people and covering up their own errors and selfish goals. Random selection of test subjects satiates the data gatherer's sense of twisted justice, for whom will be thrust into the virtual hell of dissection of their soul. There is nothing you can do to stop it if your social security number is drawn. You could pressure your political leaders to demand an independent investigation and to pass laws now, because once it happens to you, do not expect anyone to help you. You will be systematically discredited. Your fate will be sealed. What you don't know can hurt you. There is still time to stop the most abominable weapon ever conceived by humankind. They are still perfecting the artificial intelligence software for automated torture and sentence stimulation that imprisons your thought possibilities through brain entrainments apart from forced EEG heterodyning with some psychic dod moron. The echelon network for policing thoughts is incomplete and doesn't work on everyone. There are only about 200 so-called psychics, jumping around EEG heterodyning and spying into minds, so there is only a 200 out of 300 million probability that you are being spied on using this technology. Ever get that feeling you are being watched? No one ever thinks it can be done through their own eyes. George Orwell's 1984 didn't see this coming. Too bad there are not more honorable men and women willing to break the code of secrecy to allow the most important open debate in human history on the future of these weapons and uses of the technology to occur. It has far-reaching implications on religion, on how we define ourselves as a species, and on social interactions and organizations. We need the collective intelligence of the world to decide the fate of the species, because I assure you, the crippled minds that currently control the technology will not find a universally optimal use for it. The black sciences. Double toil and trouble, fire burn, and cauldron bubble. Shakespeare, Macbeth, Act 4, Scene I. As we begin our adventure, all that I promise you is a simpler, coherent model of historical events and of seemingly science fiction but real physics, with far better explanatory and predictive power, all without using magic, demonic possessions, and poltergeists to explain it. Tear open the curtain of secrecy to reveal the small men playing God. Now we are off to see the wizard. Disbelief is the common reaction. How is it possible? Most people can't escape their erroneous intuitive sense of the world. Mathematics is the language of truth. As Richard Feynman said, if you aren't deeply disturbed by quantum mechanics, you clearly haven't understood it. Relativity theory is inconceivable to most as a truth about the laws of time and space in our universe. Similarly, people will have difficulties with superconductor Josephine sensors measuring a single quantum of energy, or that your mental experiences are completely contained in the electrical properties of the brain. Deciphering the brain code has been a primary research direction, the holy grail, for most neural scientists. And they are getting very close in the civilian world to completely deciphering it. To help the skeptic reader open their mind to unbelievable scientific realities, let me illustrate some well-documented feats of science. Would you have believed someone who said that a ball weighing a kilogram of an element could destroy an entire city before the nuclear bomb was demonstrated? If someone told you that a several-ton metal tube could lift itself 30,000 feet above sea level on its own propulsion before airplanes became common, would you have believed them? Would you believe someone who claimed that they could view individual atoms, if you hadn't heard of an electron tunneling microscope? If NASA didn't post images of quasars near the edge of the known universe, would you believe that one could see 9 billion light years away, 53 trillion miles away? Some people are still in disbelief that humans have walked on the moon. Many people use mobile phones but have no idea how they work. Golf ball-sized objects are tracked from the ground in space orbit. Amateur microwave enthusiasts have bounced microwaves off the moon back to Earth, called Earth-Moon-Earth, EM. Even teleportation technology is working at a quantum scale with a phenomenon called quantum entanglement. Scientific breakthroughs are always met with skepticism before the majority of the population has been exposed to the breakthrough. Wireless EEG cloning / heterodyning has been around for 30 plus years, but the selfishness and stupidity of the scientists and military figures involved for not seeing a more important global beneficial optima for releasing this technology for medical, commercial, and other uses has stymied and hindered the collective intelligence of the population from developing it. It is currently valued more for its spying and controlling capabilities against Americans and foreign interests. Tammy, Mind, and Satan. While active denial of even the acronym Tempest, which is well known in the defense industry, is still in effect, it is the standard known to determine how much electromagnetic shielding is needed to thwart an attempt at reading the energy from monitors, TVs, or computers at a distance and reconstructing the information. This is the Tempest standard for military labs. Many have offered insight into what it might stand for. The best one I found is the electromagnetic probability estimates of safe thresholds for undetectability. These standards change with technology and guesstimates on what sensitivity other countries have implemented. More satellites or bigger dishes, the more stringent the Tempest standards need to be. MIND is the acronym for the top secret project of electromagnetic mind control. It stands for Magnetic Integrated Neuron Duplicator. This is just a fancy phrase that means EEG cloning. TAMI stands for Thought Amplifier and Mind Interface. It seems to be a second generation system built on top of MIND. The acronym for the kill mode weaponized software of this technology is SATAN, Silent Assassination Through Amplified Neurons. While the CIA has a whole bag of tricks to menticize people, the drugs can leave a trace of metabolic residue or a signature of damage that they leave in the body and brain. So SATAN has become the preferred method of silent assassination in the agencies with the best plausible denial rating. Mind magicians, mood mistros, and electronic illusionists. My interest as a child in magic sparked the interest which I have in physics, science, and psychology. Trying to understand how mental errors of assumptions could be induced in an audience by sleight-of-hand techniques and verbal cues was an astounding psychological trick to me. I loved solving the mysteries of every illusion and magic trick I have ever seen. This love of solving mysteries continued throughout my life. There are almost no black boxes left for me to understand. I have taken apart every appliance and machine ever made. Later in life, I wanted to understand the most complex pieces of machinery on the planet, humans. I have explored many fascinating minds from all walks of life and cultures on this planet except for one segment. Sociopathic, unquestioningly obedient, or Schadenfreude-diseased people have eluded me on how they are created. I generally try to rid myself of negative people in my life. So this knowledge is something I did not seek, it found me. Sociopaths occur both naturally from childhood traumas, genetics, or life experiences affecting people in unpredictable ways. Of interest to the CIA and some military divisions with assassins is how to create them. How can a Manchurian candidate or programmed assassin be created is the question the Gultrum mind control experiments help answer. There have been many books written by survivors and experts in this area that I list in the appendix, so I won't go into every detail of the program that continues to this day. The basic steps that they use in the extreme can be experienced in milder forms such as boot camp in the military or cults. The only new twist to these horrific acts of experimentation and brutality to children and others destined by the corrupt elements in the government to perform programmed assassinations on command is that the Gultra programming can now be done completely wirelessly using TAMI, and various neural programming techniques. Less evidence, fewer memories, and more plausible denial makes this a great leap forward for the Gultra mind control chuckleheads who operate the systems and who are undoubtedly programmed using similar techniques. For example, if you believe the Columbine shootings were caused by Marilyn Manson lyrics or hidden backwards messages on rock music like the investigation tried to finger, then why wouldn't you believe that the military/CIA wouldn't use rock music and subliminal programming to kill people? Their tactics and technology of mind control and subliminal persuasion is so much more advanced than these simple messaging techniques. You are naive to believe such things caused the shootings. Please pay attention, ignore the man behind the curtain. This is how the mind melding works. EEG cloning, i.e. mind melding, or synchronizing of brainwaves has been known for half a century. The German Nazi scientists conducted countless brutal medical dissection on Jews. Not only were the Nazis close to building an atomic bomb, but from these experiments they had figured out how to control the human mind with just electromagnetic energy. These scientists were divided up between the Russians and the United States after World War II. They were brought over to the United States under Project Paperclip. For their loyalty, they were forgiven for their war crimes. The United States and USSR began a new arms race. The first population-wide system came online sometime between 1953 and 1960. These systems often are guised as over-the-horizon radar or ionosphere research projects. Any sufficiently advanced technology will appear like magic to a lesser technologically advanced civilization. Isaac Asimov. The most basic mode first discovered was a simple amplification of brain waves. There are a couple patents that describe this in detail in the patent office. By feeding back EEG-like waveforms into the same brain, one amplifies thoughts. There are two types of brain amplification. One amplifies the synaptic modulation and the other amplifies brain entrainments, that is inducing more neurons to join a firing group at each pass or presentation of a stimuli. This is apparent from the project acronyms, TAMI and SATAN. In this mode, one experiences sounds louder, vision brighter, and an ad. Attention deficit disorder, like condition. It also leads to a paranoid schizophrenic condition over time. It is a good way to incapacitate a target, as the military literature describes. In the patents that define this system, they used directed microwaves. But now what happens if you instead amplify one person's EEG signals by some method into another person's brain? That person would begin to think like the persons whose brain waves were being cloned onto him. They in fact, by all intensive purposes, become that person to a great extent. I'll leave the philosophy of this up to others. These people who have this done to them by choice or force are called psychics. It turns out that there are many methods and biochemical and biophysical mechanisms to induce synchronized brain entrainments. Three recent Sony patents use ultrasonics to transfer the energy and signals. Other researchers have used magnetic coils and electromagnetic frequencies that seem to traverse the spectrum up through microwaves. Even the modes of neural pathway induction vary from pulsed waveforms encoded by the pulse duration and timings to continuous ELF amplitude and phase modulated signals. It appears from the literature that many things work. Even sound and light flashing can entrance or entrain people's brains to follow the simple patterns. Now, the third big area of research for the CIA in the past that leaves one scratching their heads as why our tax dollars would be going towards that endeavor is splitting personalities. Splitting personalities was a mechanism used to create and control the old-fashioned mind slave spies. The CIA call themselves handlers of these people. But interestingly enough, the effect of a hive mind is to create what appears to be a split personality if one didn't look behind the curtain to see who was pulling the levers. The hive mind EEG cloning experiments involve 2 to 6 people, typically in a test cell. Cloning someone's mind onto someone else changes their personality and behavior. But in the best conditions, the entire body and will are taken over. Forced speech is one of the unsettling capabilities of the technology and the term used by people who have been given demonstrations of it. The best way to describe what a neural link feels like in a medium-intensity cloning signal is it is a cell phone call with the caller's voice, emotion, and some physical urges transferred while they speak. This is why many victims talk to themselves. They actually are talking to someone else. With cell phone headsets getting smaller, more people are being accused of being crazy or being psychic. If the target does not move his/her mouth when the other people talk but he/she talks back by using his/her mouth, he/she is said to be talking to him/herself as psychologists describe. but if the person moves their mouth in sync with the speech from the cloner due to the cloning link intensity, they have multiple personalities according to the shrinks. In a strange way, they do have separate personalities. The neural modulation from the external cloning signal conveys certain aspects of the transferred brain entrainments. However, the target's sense of self is not usually lost due to the external cloning signal and the other person is still perceived as separate, much like how one doesn't get confused by a telephone conversation. Now, what if someone used voice transformation software and threw your own voice while you were talking on the phone using an earpiece? Could your mind get confused as to what was said by you and your sense of self blurred? Everyone gets a different subset of involuntary experiments conducted on them, but only a few get the whole shebang. The patterns are obvious. I am no Sherlock Holmes and I solved this age-old riddle in less than 6 months of interviewing people. Don't tell me that the most inept FBI agent investigating these X-Files couldn't have solved it. The corruption and conspiracy are very real in this country. Mind magicians use sleight of mind tricks through strategic distractions. The government uses this technique all the time. The Iraq war is somewhat of a planned distraction away from what is happening domestically. More overtly, there have been many examples where strategic media leaks occur in order to change the focus of attention of the nation. Bush used it when he got caught with his NSA scandal. He tried to focus the attention on the whistleblowers rather than his illegal domestic spying practices. Even the NSA domestic spying scandal can be viewed as a charade compared to psychic spying and torturing of thousands of Americans. It pales in comparison as a newsworthy topic. Do you comprehend the magnitude of this discovery and technology yet? In the EEG hive mind, with equal weighting amongst all the participants, you have a severe problem with multiple foci of attention creating attention deficient disorder-like symptoms. By reconfiguring the hive mind into a tree-like structure of EEG influence, the shared brain waves are more manageable. Also, after spending a lot of time adapting to each other's thoughts, there is less mental conflict. However, as a weapon, the tactic of diverting a thought of a target can be extremely useful in controlling their decisions or actions. Stupid alien tricks. Laughter is the best medicine. It helps us emotionally cope with potentially uncomfortable situations and slowly integrate disturbing new information. So, throughout our voyage we will be periodically entertained by the ship of fools in a segment called Stupid Alien Tricks. The first and most important stupid alien trick is to make the target think that the aliens have the capability to cause heart attacks or strokes. This is almost a universal prank and was used on Saddam Hussein in 1992 according to USA Today. Remember that with EEG heterodyning, the electromagnetic matrix, you only die if you believe that you can die. It is the panic and paranoia that causes the heart to race ever faster and causes the target to do irrational things dangerous to themselves. I know magicians are never supposed to reveal their tricks, but here is how it is done. During an attack, the brain waves of the attacker are more strongly amplified onto the target and the target's brain waves are only lightly amplified into the attacker. Simply by the psychic assailant pressing on their chest, spinning in their chair, and being out of shape and having their heart rate speed up from spinning in their chair, these sensations feel very scary to the target. They feel their heart pounding out of their chest. They feel the pain in their chest. And they are getting dizzy. The assailants can even make their left arm numb or cold by putting it in water to further the illusion. All the sensations are amplified into the target's mind. There will be more detail on this remote-controlled heart attack methodology later in the book, that was first described by Russian psychics back in the 1970s. The psychic army needs to practice on civilians because in my case the attacker thought the heart was in the right side of the chest. This spoiled the illusion for me. Silly aliens, tricks are for kids. Brain mapping and normalization software. You can get free brain mapping software from open source forums. The trick here is to align brain signatures. If the same stimulus is given to two individuals, their whole brain patterns will be close but different enough that it may make them incompatible for raw EEG heterodyning. Let's say a word is presented to two humans with similar cultures, their brains will produce similar waveforms for the given frequencies of interest and cascading sequences. That is the key. One must analyze the time sequence of the cognitive model. A famous example of this is called the multiple segment truck backing up problem. I used back propagation neural networks to demonstrate it. The exact mathematical modeling doesn't matter as much as one would think. As Stephen Wolfram concludes in his book, A New Kind of Science, computation equivalence gives rise to the exact same subjective manifestation or model that we experience as consciousness. The cover of this book shows a mock graphical presentation of the DoD's brain mapping application. The only screenshot that I nearly exactly replicated was the psychic warfare training program nicknamed, the Pain Game. The others I doctored to improve on their design. brain signal filtering software. The other amazing technology that they have been working on for EEG heterodyning is brainwave sequence filtering. Clearly, when you mind meld with someone and you are the interrogator, you don't want them to read your bluffs or information from your brain. So they have developed frequency time filters to isolate types of brain information from being transferred. I am happy to report that they are still very flawed, and certain scanning and probing techniques that I will explain in detail in my next book work quite well at hacking the hacker's mind. The Science Channel produced a documentary called Spied R Us. It has an episode on the CIA methods of hacking the human mind. But in that episode you will see the sleight of hand technique so often used. They talk about putting a video camera on flying model airplanes for surveillance around corners as a new CIA investment. This is to mislead people how advanced the state of the art actually is. I have a model airplane I built 15 years ago that does the same thing. There is a mechanical dragonfly in the CIA museum from 1970 that was a working spy cam. This is how your tax dollars are wasted just to mislead you, because you can't be trusted. Without the cloak and dagger ego currency for the boys that never grow up, how could they motivate this army of retards to attack their own people for weapons data? The psychic wars. I can't believe my business school classmates at Dartmouth would joke about how smart I was by asking me if I have been bending any spoons lately with my mind, and now I am writing about psychic wars. Truth is stranger than fiction. One objective of psychic attacks, or more accurately called EEG heterodyning attacks, is to screw up someone's visual perception. This is done by the EEG cloner, almost always unbeknownst to the target. The psychic soldiers practice this mental trickery routinely in psychic war games conducted on people worldwide and talked about by Dr. Becker in a CNN interview on these weapons back in the 80s. I have been able to compile a comprehensive list of practiced illusions from my countless interviews with test subjects around the United States and the demonstration I was given. Referring to the Malak patent by Dorn and Company, the apparatus can detect if someone is hallucinating or cause hallucinations in them. The black magic practiced by the psychic warriors is mostly illusions and tricks of the mind. The game of psychic soldiers is to cause errors in thinking and perceiving. When brainwaves are mixed, i.e. heterodyned, any auditory or visual misperceptions, that is errors, are transferred to the target. So psychic soldiers practice perceiving visual errors. Like one who stares at an autostereogram, see cover of book, if you relax your eye gaze, the dots below in the picture form a 3D pattern in your brain. This is an error of perception because there is no real object there. Oddly enough, this is what it takes to be a psychic attack soldier. In a near-sensory deprivation setting, the heterodyned attacker sees in his mind's eye the same visual scene as the target. By focusing on bringing objects into the foreground that are normally in the background causes a parallax visual perception error in the target. This can be devastating while driving, since only road markers can be seen as cues to stay on the road at night. Flying at night like JFK Jr. did would pose another serious risk of disorientation. The attacker can also cross their eyes or focus on perceiving movement visually to disorient the target. You can try this yourself by turning your TV onto a station with just white noise. If you practice and concentrate, you can see the noise moving in any direction you want or cause other spinning patterns and such that are not truly there. It is almost purely random visual noise, but your expectations of what you think you should see cause the visual processing algorithms in your brain to converge on a faulty solution of the ill-posed vision problem. If the connection is strong, shadows and fully conjured images can be overlaid into the target's visual cortex. A strong connection depends on many factors discussed later. This random dot autostereogram features a raised shark with fine gradient on a flat background. From http://en.wikipedia.org/wiki/autostereogram. Another capability of the system is to drive the target crazy with voices, as one colonel published. This is like having a crying baby in a cell phone you can't turn off duct tape to each ear. If the conversation is bad enough, it could drive someone crazy over time. Another colonel said, if you can project voices into the enemy, I will talk them to their death. More likely to be used during a holy war, is being able to fake the voice of God, as the weapon's capability is often termed, and order them to lay down their arms or kill their comrades. More useful are the subliminal suggestions that can influence their actions and opinions without them being fully aware of the influence. We have gone so deep into the hole following this stupid white rabbit that we have almost reached hell. Stupid alien tricks. So, I admit it. I fell for it. Almost every victim tries the same defensive shielding approaches at great cost. Part of the strategy of the weapons testers is to deplete the victims of financial resources while by forcing the victims to spend all their money on defense research. One of the shielding approaches that everyone thinks of is a Faraday cage. It is supposed to stop low-frequency electric fields, but as one finds out, cell phones work in them, so they can't be that effective. Anyway, once I was completely contained in my Faraday cage, the abusive testers said, "Look, we caged our human animal. Now the real experiments can begin." I have to admit that I laughed aloud. They indeed have imprisoned me both physically and mentally now. Score 1 for the aliens. Examples of electronic warfare capabilities and other types of directed energy. The same radar and global surveillance grid of directed energy can be used for many other purposes than just human nervous system manipulation and disruption. Just through a satellite signal, the many segments of the United States power grid could be taken out. One capability that my EEG heterodyned experimenters told me about was that not only can they capture all electronic device signals and play them back like car locks, alarm systems and garage door openers, is that they can simultaneously hack all garage door opening systems in the United States, causing a power surge that will shut down power in many metropolitan cities, especially California, where consumption is at a critical capacity. Or they could set off all car alarm systems simultaneous, causing havoc. They even are working on testing a theory that they will blame on cyber terrorists. A computer virus that turns the computer into a radio frequency emitter that can hack external systems like garage doors at a specific time to see if they can cause a massive power outage with just a computer virus. The Russians were blamed for the computer virus called Satan 666 that was to cause heart arrhythmias by sending psychotronic signals through a computer monitor, but I suspect it came from the same source as most domestic espionage. Remember the game: more terrorism, more fear, more money, and power for the defense industry. But more disturbingly, these power-obsessed agents bragged about how other Star Wars initiative weapons they have access to could destroy most life on Earth. How, by systematically burning down all the world's forests and suffocating much of the life that requires oxygen. I'm sure it is true, since making powerful CO2 lasers that can start fires up to 2 miles away can be done by hobbyists. But don't fear, the aliens have nukes that could do it much quicker anyway. In addition, oxygen can be manufactured artificially. The military has documents that discuss hacking 802.11b wireless standard from their communications command structures. So even if your computer isn't connected to the internet, if you leave your wireless link on, the tax dollar funded crooks can hack you. The first week when I was abducted, someone started hacking my computers from instead of AngelNet. I put tripwires in my system to see what they were looking for. They end up purging 7 years of my digital life. Obviously AngelNet could have been a reference to the book Angels Don't Play This Harp, and they were boldly saying that the harp antenna field has the ability to hack and read computers in this hemisphere. I assumed at the time it was a neighbor within 100 feet of my dwelling who was hacking my system as I watched them. I hate cyber terrorists and psychoterrorists. I am extremely disappointed that the majority of terrorism and psychos can be tracked right back to the CIA/Shadow government. Stupid alien tricks. In order to test their abilities to intercept mobile phone communication and scramble it, the aliens exercise their power in several ways with the integrated signal and communication intelligence systems. Their cell phone jammers work quite well. Most victims describe no matter how often they move, this scenario occurs. They choose a location and check to make sure it gets great mobile phone reception. Once they move in, their mobile phone reception drops to zero after a week. My neurally linked brethren enjoyed telling me when I was about to receive a call on my phone, or they would tell me that I missed a call and often who it was. Other capabilities demonstrated on me, for example, one time when I called myself to record license plates of alien paparazzi, stalkers, on my voicemail, they told me to listen to the messages that I left myself. To my amazement, they had scrambled the packets from my phone to the message center. It was like every quarter second the voice information was reversed. So I sounded like I was speaking an alien language and the content was unintelligible for all of the messages. This capability was used in Operation Desert Storm on Iraqi generals with voice transformation software to mimic other generals. Back to unraveling the Matrix metaphor. In the movie, the heroes would get pulled out of electromagnetic matrix by a phone call. The reason for this is because the technology is based on the CIA program RHIC, Remote Hypnotic Intracerebral Control. The loud startling ringing of a phone breaks the hypnotic spell temporarily and pulls one out of the electromagnetic matrix world. Hypnosis is used both as a weapon and a necessary synchronized state for a strong bidirectional neural link. Aliens suck. We need to capture and dissent them to see what makes them so evil and sociopathic if we are to stop the spread of this cultural virus, this disease of the collective consciousness. Architecture of the Matrix. During the experiments, the data collectors perform tests of sentence completion and prediction probabilities. In another mode of TAMI, what sounds like multiple threads simultaneously running, about 10 to 20 possible completions of your precognitive thoughts or partially begun sentences are spoken back to you. They called these programs memecants. Each one completed the thought or sentence differently. It was like a matrix of probabilities of previous sentence patterns used to guess like fill in the blank sentence completion on the SATs. It sounded exactly like the scene in the Matrix where Neo meets the architect. I have worked in both industry and for the Department of Defense on pattern recognition systems and artificial intelligence. I recognized much of my own type of work in Tammy's algorithms. Every classification category has a confidence metric associated with it. Sentence completion, word, image, and object recognition, etc., works on the same principles. Rather than just speaking back to the target the most probable speech pattern for completion, the top 10 responses were spoken back simultaneously. My mind seems to be too complex for their sentence completion algorithms to accurate forecast, and almost every thought sonorization was incorrect, but close enough for government work. Resonant feed-forward neural network for speech recognition. If you aren't a geek, you may want to skip this section. There are many artificial neural network models. One popular one is called backpropagation. Speech recognition software often uses classification algorithms called Markov modeling. All statistical classification algorithms have slightly different trade-offs in terms of ease of programming, invariance, and necessary training data set size. There are two interesting observations to point out with Tammy. The Stanford Research Institute demonstrated an EEG inner voice recognition system back in the 70s. It classified certain brainwaves of a person's thinking about speaking a word and it recognized the phonetic decomposition and spoke it aloud from a computer. This technology went black for several decades. Sequential brainwave entrainments for speech recognition in the Wernicke Center of the Human Brain. The other discovery for civilian scientists I would like to emphasize during the technology transfer demonstration for me by the DOD/CIA is that language, words, and sentences are created from time-sequenced frequency modes. That means that word understanding is a combination of sound perception, possibly induced by the microwave hearing effect, at the primitive level and the state of prior presentations of the brain phonetic recognition resonant frequencies. So this means that the understanding of language only requires the correct sequence of induced currents in the brain based on achieving the new resonant state and not dependent on the exact timing between each state transition for the final recognition of a word. This is intuitive based on Markov models and resonant neural network state-dependent model theory. This is where the output of the neural network is looped back as the next state or inputs into the beginning of the network. Demonstrations of precognitive phoneme, word, and sentence classification, a subsystem of TAMI. People speak in fairly predictable sentence patterns. The sentence predictor software learns an individual's sentence patterns over months of training samples, correlating the precognitive word formations with the actual utterances. This system is a demonstration of precognitive recognition and classification of intent and would allow split-second faster reaction times if it were a physical intention that was being predicted. The Navy has done the most research in this area in regards to reading EEG signals for faster reaction times. However, this software's actual purpose is to be used to help with locking onto a host mind by helping the psychic soldier begin the same cognitive and linguistic brain patterns as the host so as to synchronize the entrainments more precisely. That is the main goal for psychic warriors. Better they become at locking on, adapting their minds to the host, the more control they have over the host mind, will, and then body and better they can experience the target's thoughts, that is mind reading. The system repeats phrases over and over again to lock the host mind into that linguistic pattern until the host and target minds match above some threshold. Here is a screenshot inside the United States Psychic War Room, I mean the Borg Cube. The waveform on the left is some visual transformation of the psychic attacker's brain entrainments and activity and the one on the right is the target. The graph in the middle below is a differential overlay of the two people and useful as visual feedback for the cloning army solider to acquire a lock-on. For a personality type that is not in the human mind database, EEG cloning takes a while to occur. The target unbeknownst to them are receiving the modulated brain signals of the attacker and vice versa. The neural networks of the combined mind begin to self-organize the shared data. In addition to the self-organizing feature of neural networks, the software behind the scenes is doing autocorrelation with some human intervention to map and align the variances of the two minds to speed along the process to full cloning capability. One simple method of breaking the cloning lock involves word games. By speaking nonsensical sentences that can't be predicted by the software and that the other person must think about to understand, the mind patterns separate for a brief time until the psychic attacker can reacquire the host brain patterns. Bilingual speakers can break the lock by switching to another language. Inner voice conversations, which are difficult if not impossible to avoid, strengthens the link, increasing all the shared perceptions, especially higher order mental functions like concepts. This is one of the main purposes of what is termed voice to skull. Longer a lock can be broken or disrupted, the more time it takes for it to be reacquired. See the section on antipsychotronic theory for technologies that help break this lock. Neuromarketing has appeared many times in innovation and then disappeared. If the microwave hearing effect can be used to pipe in voice commands directly into the subconscious mind, you can imagine how powerful a marketing tool it would be. But for now, the DOT and intelligence communities circle around like vultures to intimidate any who works on such technologies. This is still a forbidden area of research. You must go abroad to work on it. ELISA and natural language processing using phonemes from brain waves. The Gultra programming also adds an element of automation to creating your private purgatory. ELISA was a computer program back in the 70s which demonstrated artificial intelligence. It acted like a psychologist and asked stupid questions and responded to answers. It would parse and understand sentences. This field is called NLP natural language processing, not to be confused with NLP neuro-linguistic programming. ELISA fooled about half the people who communicated with it into believing it was a real human being on the other end. Now, fast forward 35 years and instead of parsing natural language phrases from keystrokes, it recognizes phonetic brainwaves and parses them into words and sentences for artificial intelligence and natural language processing. This was demonstrated by the Stanford Research Institute in the 70s. Now the tortures and mentalizations can scale to entire populations through this automation. I call one of TAMI's functions a sentence stimulator. For many of the test subjects, they describe the conversations in their head as very artificial and with almost no intelligence and very repetitive and limited in terms of topics of discussion. This would describe about the current state of the art. Artificial intelligence and natural language processing were other areas of interest that I studied at Harvard. I worked on a program that was to show emotion based on the probable frustration level of the computer user, which was based on the frequency of errors and crashes. The brainwave cognitive ELISA adds realism by inducing an empathetic emotion with the words that the target feels. This adds a new dimension of convincing information that the synthetic mind virus is a real person. Neuro-linguistic programming, NLP, was first introduced into the army and pursued as a weapon by the infamous Colonel John Alexander. These brainwashing techniques fit quite intuitively into the capabilities of TAMI. I endured about 2 months of this kind of repetitive programming, which basically consists of repetitive overt suggestion, very similar to a technique called psychic driving invented by the CIA paid torture specialist Dr. E. Cameron. It wasn't very effective on me, so I'm not very impressed by the technique and think that NLP masters are joke profession. However, the national anthem psychically driven at every sporting event seems to work quite well. However, due to the large numbers of people that this is done to and the often full-time aspect of the constant babble, it would make sense that they would switch over the live hive mind participants to an automated system so that they could move on while both maintaining the illusion of a live neural link and a psychosis that never heals. Then only a single moderator would be needed to monitor the interactions of several targets in case the link failed for any number of reasons. Synthetic telepathy. Phoneme recognition uses some brain waves from the premotor cortex for tongue, mouth, and throat and the audio cortex recall to be amplified and rebroadcast into another mind, which is then perceived as speech and sound. It turns out that speech is not encrypted in the brain as much as one would think. There is a direct mapping between sound recall and speech phonemes with their audio wave analog. This was first demonstrated with EEG probes at the Stanford Research Institute. Design flaws with TAMI. TAMI has a voice recognition interface that the EEG cloners use during collection of internal sentences for training TAMI's precognitive sentence prediction software. The cloners would say "Shut up, TAMI," as a computer voice recognized phrase, in order to increase the recognition threshold confidences. The problem with the interface design is that the attacker can be hacked by the target. The system does not distinguish between any of the internal voices of the collective hind mind. See hacking the eye gaze tracker interface. System flaws with TAMI. As with any system where a signal is amplified and fed back to the sensor, oscillations can occur known as feedback. This also applies to amplified brain waves. They are working on finding fixes for these feedback conditions. Two examples can be found in synthetic telepathy. The first kind of feedback loop occurs at the phrase level, where a decaying echo of the phrase is heard and repeated. The second one is at a sound perception level. Almost everyone who is EEG heterodyned and not just cloned, hears a tinnitus at some point. If a psychic cloner is just replicating your brain waves onto his, there is no feedback loop. Feedback only occurs when the psychic is trying to influence you in a two-way brain entrainment lock. The tinnitus is caused by several signals, but the loudest steady-state tone is due to the feedback loop generated from the host's hearing, being amplified to the parasite and mixed with his brainwaves, and then amplified again and sent back to the host. The feedback frequency is usually around 11,111 Hz. Like with a microphone too close to a speaker, they have come up with some unusual ways to break the feedback loop. The feedback is automatically detected and a strong secondary pulsing frequency is injected that is slightly off the feedback frequency, which overpowers the conscious focus on the feedback base frequency. This slight change of attention in the brain dampens the tinnitus frequency attenuation and returns the signals to controlled levels and synthetic telepathy can again be heard. This flaw can be a point of detection and defense. Using a tone generator, a target can identify his/her feedback frequency. Playing an overpowering sound at the tinnitus frequency with various modulations, preferably into each ear, will lock into place the feedback loop, thereby rendering a voice to skull attack void. However, the annoying high pitch ring is distracting and could still cause some decreased attention to tasks at hand. Another method the weapons designers came up with is to distract the target's attention from the feedback frequency using body jerks. A sequence of small, random limb jerks automatically begins when the feedback frequency is maintained for a few seconds. This too can dampen the brainwave amplification of that signal in order to regain two-way communications. The brain signals of sound perception that are causing feedback are a transformation of actual frequencies, so the appropriateness of the analogy of a microphone too close to the speaker is limited. Even longer time frame feedback loops exist in heterodyned hive minds. Everyone has encountered something like this while just walking down the street. You see an oncoming pedestrian and you veer to the left. At the same time, the pedestrian veers to his right. You then respond by correcting the other way, and in return he does too. You find yourselves in a comedic dance with a stranger. Most victims of government practice torture and kill programs die unnatural deaths from car crashes, heart attacks, suicide, and cancer that the weapons test program managers justify mostly as secondary effects from the testing. While there are many purposeful attempts to make people crash, most crashes are probably caused by secondary effects. Driving while talking on the cell phone has been compared to being legally drunk in terms of increased risks due to the distraction. Similarly, voice-to-skull harassment is a much more profound distraction with proportionately increased risks. But an anomalous feedback loop of physical intentions also occurs, decreasing the ability of a target to operate a plane or vehicle properly. EEG hive mind participants share almost every desire, from hunger to scratching an itch. When one person is driving and pressing on the gas or brake pedal, the other people in the hive mind have the urge to tap their foot. Their urge to tap their foot is amplified back to the driver, who then presses harder or softer on the gas. It leads to a very jerky ride. It is the same comedic dance that occurs with pedestrians avoiding each other. In engineering, this feedback system is called resonance or instability due to under-dampening of the signal. In response to these higher-level brain-patterned resonances, brainwave filtering methods are being developed to dampen all these abnormalities that occur in the most wasteful and unnatural configurations of brains currently being researched, called EEG-cloned hive minds. This is how your tax dollars are being wasted and keeping the aliens on welfare. Stupid alien tricks. The aliens often amused themselves by leaving clues in their words spoken to their projects. One of the phrases they repeated over and over again to me was, "You are the one." This is a clear reference to Neo in the movie The Matrix, who everyone referred to as the one. Neo was the one whom the Oracle prophesized would save the humans from the machines. Well, as I conducted more research, to my surprise the pitch of my newly acquired tinnitus was exactly 11,111. The aliens laughed at my discovery and it was never mentioned again. I hate aliens. Screenshot of Satan's GUI, eye gaze tracking interface. To start up a torture, the eyes drag the menu item to a sandbox area that activate it. Another menu on the sandbox shows a menu list of all active tortures, and by selecting one and dragging it back to the other menu area, it is deactivated. The lettering on the pull-down menu items have a cryptic language on them. It looks like a combination of Russian, Greek, English, Egyptian, Japanese, and Chinese characters with a hieroglyphic twist. Remember the matrix code that drips down the screen? For each menu item in the eye gaze interface, there is a unique blend of symbols derived from the various languages of the planet. It was created so that it can be used by and on any nationality in the world without clues to the real country of origin doing the attacking, in case there is a visual filter breach and the target sees the screen. That is why it looks both alien and native. The Matrix code characters which stream down the screen are really just the pull-down menus expanding and then submenus expanding with this language-independent interface. Interesting to see how it was interpreted in the movie. See the document in the appendix on NASA's mind control program with children. NASA conducted mind control on children as testified by an astronaut. The children who are grown up now were involved in Gultra-like programs and have recovered most of their memories. One child says that they were trained to read intergalactic symbols developed by NASA for the purpose of communicating with extraterrestrial civilizations. It is these symbols that are used on the Satan torture and psychic warfare interface that I have seen and approximated in the screenshots in the movie, The Matrix. They were not developed for speaking to extraterrestrial aliens, but just the evil ones born here on Earth. Scary alien quotes. Will you tell anyone that we planned the assassination of Kennedy and screwed up Michael Dukakis's speeches? We've done this to so many doctors, none of whom could figure it out. We are going to turn a Harvard grad into a homeless bum within a year unless you can stop us. If you can do it to you, we can do it to anyone. Capabilities and uses of Tammy, Satan, and mind. Remote-controlled heart attacks, don't panic. There are two methods used to induce heart attacks by electromagnetic energy. Here is the trick behind the first method of remote-controlled heart attacks and how you can defend against them. It was theorized by Russian scientists that a runaway adrenal panic process in conjunction with stimulating the heart to beat faster and causing some vasoconstriction could lead to a heart attack. This was done on me several times where I passed out on one occasion, but I am young and healthy. It would definitely work on the elderly. It is mostly a head game. It is true that they can speed up the heart rate with EEG brain waves. Many of the brain waves are above 60 Hz, and they can cause vasoconstriction, but the designer of us in his great wisdom made it nearly impossible for our minds, even in extreme fear and panic, to kill the body or literally to be scared to death. The best motto for an EEG clone remote control heart attack attempt is, if it is satanic, don't panic. If you know how the effect works and you have beta blockers or Valium on hand, it will be impossible for them to accomplish it. They will cause imaginary heart pains. They will make your left arm feel cold and numb. Check your pulse, it will be within tolerable limits. It is merely a trick to make you think they have this capability. Beta blockers block the signal from the brain that will increase the heart rate. Many people suffer panic attacks that they mistake for heart attacks and call an ambulance. I would bet that when all is known in 20 or 30 years on these mass experiments on the public, that panic attacks will drop off significantly because most are caused by the weapons testing groups without the microwave hearing effect telling them what is happening. All the voice-to-skull attacks on people are scripted performances by the human effects weapons testers. They follow the exact same series of events with just the details tailored to the individual. It is very advantageous to the humans that the machine is predictable and uncreative. Here are the main points of panic that they will use against a victim who hasn't read this book. 1. Your brain is being fried by microwaves. There is a 5% increase risk for brain and other cancers for these experiments according to my government sources, but this is insignificant compared to the number of years of your life they take through the stress of believing they are cooking you. 2. Once you understand what EEG cloning is, you can see how ridiculous these big bad psychic attackers really are. Everything you feel, they feel amplified and vice versa. They have developed a few brainwave filters for certain types of brain activity, but on the most part, you both are of one single mixed mind. So they might say, we are giving you a stroke. You will feel a strange sensation like what you might imagine as blood leaking into your head. While in reality, the psychic attacker puts water on his/her hands and is dampening their scalp. It really is this pathetic. This is like when children pretend they are breaking eggs on other children's head by slowly running their fingers in a spreading gelatinous mess-like motion. 3. We are cooking your heart muscle. The psychic attackers press on their chest or play a pre-recorded heartache to further this illusion of mind. Remember, in these mind control experiments, it is only brain waves that are being manipulated, no matter how real anything feels. You can't trust any of your senses. 4. We are going to kill your entire family and all your friends if you tell anyone. Quite the opposite is true. Informing a few trusted friends what is happening would more likely keep you from disappearing without a trace. Do not go to the police or FBI. They will lock you up in the psych ward. That probably should go for all rape victims, mental rapes, or physical. Most authorities are not smart enough or educated enough to understand the physics behind these weapons, so don't bother trying to update them. Many hundreds have tried and failed. You will learn in time that all the threats made by synthetic telepathy from guys probably based in Virginia are empty. 5. If they are able to raise your sensitivity levels to paranoid through the stalking program and threats, you will begin to attribute every bad luck event in your life to them. This creates an illusion that they have lots of power over your life. Be logical and practice double-checking your conclusions. 6. We have the police in our pockets and they will plant drugs on you. While there are a few CIA and other agents posing as California Highway Patrol that might do that, there is still no reason to panic because there is nothing you can do to avoid that level of corruption. Deal with it if it happens the best you can. 7. Also, once they have you believing that they are going to destroy everything in your life that you value, your mind starts thinking of ways they might do it. EEG cloning allows the psychic attackers to read every little fear that crosses your mind and they are trained to use them against you. Remember that. Practiced positive thinking can help thwart this kind of attack of using your own mind against you. 8. Visual imagery of demons and such that victims report as holograms or materializations are often used to frighten the more superstitious and religious types. This is the traditional haunting and ghost imagery method. I do not want to take away from the fact that the prolonged experimental process is incredibly debilitating due both to the constant various pain and a severe distraction of noise piped into your head. It will, to say the least, ruin your life as you had planned it. But you need to accept your temporary slavery status, and move towards educating more people. The mass information streams have been locked up, so grassroots efforts and some creative thinking is needed to scale and spread this information. Remember the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy's advice, don't panic. The second method of remote-controlled heart attacks is more direct. The heart, like the brain, uses patterns of electrical signals to maintain its function. Disrupting the regular electrical pattern can, under certain circumstances, cause fibrillation or, over prolonged periods, heart arrhythmias. Precisely timed pulses or electrical resonance modulation of the heart will cause the heart to skip a beat and decrease the overall compression force of each stroke. These more direct methods can be thwarted with a thick leather jacket, many test survivors have stated. Leather acts like an external skin and absorbs much of the radar energy before entering the body. However, I was a bit cocky during these remote assassination attempts and let them do their worst for 5 hours until they gave up and were convinced that this method was not enough to work on me. These are the weapons of silent assassination being touted as non-lethal because their dial-in effects kill settings are still not satisfactorily predictable. Staying alive.